Well, it looked like and sounded like a heavy morning shower, but folks in one Kansas City neighborhood knew better. They started the day with yet another water main break outside their door. KMBC 9's Maria Antonia is live to show us how often they're facing this problem. Maria?
Indeed, they are facing it often, Laura. We're on the corner of 67th Street and Scenic Drive. Good news is these folks with the Water Services Department behind me are wrapping up repairs, and people in this neighborhood who've spent the day without water, they tell me, are about to get their water service restored. But for the folks in this area, this is a case of deja vu all over again.
It's more redundant than refreshing for folks in this neighborhood.
This happened last week.
This is not the first, not the second. But the third break here in the last couple of weeks, according to the Water Services Department.
We've also had chronic breaks. Every two or three years, we have one of these episodes somewhere in this block.
Ruth and Jim found themselves at home without water for 2 days last week. The break had cars stopping for what seemed like a wash, but there's more than just water in that spray. You could see pieces of asphalt flying across, and while that man on a bicycle worked around the worst of it, you could hear what sounds like one car getting pelted. In that hole, we are told, is a 6-inch main busted again from the pressure of higher water use during hot weather.
Seems like it'd be cheaper to replace the whole pipe than to fix it one piece at a time.
Unlike smaller 2- and 4-inch lines that are slated for replacement, the water department tells us this one is not.
What is interesting is that Kansas City never issues a boil warning and everybody else does. Do you want to notice that?
Beautiful to see, but not good.
And what you're seeing right now is an effort to let some of the water out and relieve some of the pressure on this line. Again, they're wrapping up repairs here. You heard one man raise the issue of a boil order. The Water Services Department tells us they do water sampling after they do repairs, and that takes care of that. Now, what they do suggest is that folks in this area do flush their lines. And Lara is back in the studio with information on the right way to do that. Lara?
All right, Maria. Well, whether you lose water pressure or water service altogether, the department suggests flushing your lines by letting the water run for 5 to 10 minutes. And if you have an aerator, remove it to clear dirt that might have gotten stuck in it.